Today I'm going to be unboxing and taking a look at this Elecrow Panel CM4 Pi Terminal display that Elecrow sent me to show you guys. They're not paying me for this, and they don't get any say in what I tell you. I'm just going to take a look at the hardware and unbox it and maybe play with it a little bit. I don't think I'm going to do a lot of software messing around today, but we shall see what this thing is. They seem to have designed it to act as a fully functioned PLC gateway or tablet PC or Node RED device. It's got a bunch of different hardware interfaces and whatnot on it. Claims to be IP65 rated for dustproof and waterproof on the front panel. And supports various different wireless communication protocols, all powered by a Raspberry Pi compute module 4. So let's see what's in the box. I got a bit of paperwork here. Little manual, that's nice. What is this? Oh, they've got a contest going on. Okay, cool. I bet you that's on their website. We're more interested in what hardware's in the box. First off, I find three antennas. So as mentioned on the outside of the box, it's got various different wireless communications capabilities. So I'm assuming that's what those are for. We have... Oh, it's GPS antenna. Okay. Box didn't say anything about that. So it's also capable of knowing where it is in the world. Cool. We have a power-up supply. North American standard. Nice. 12 volt, 2 amps. Universal input power. And we have a couple of little connector blocks over here. Three of them. You just plug in and they... have little clampy-do bits here for the wires. Okay, that's cool. I think I've seen this kind before. Not quite sure what they're called. Maybe the manual will say. And under here, we have the main event. Just to rip that bag open. So there we have the touchscreen front panel. Very nice and slick. And on the back here, peel that out. Oh, we got a description of all the different interfaces. Okay, cool. Along the top, we have four different antenna connections, an LTE antenna, GPS antenna, Wi-Fi, and LoRa. So this one, they asked me which one I wanted, and I chose the LTE / 4G / 3G cellular modem rather than the LoRa, because they don't have any other LoRa stuff around here. So... I might knock a SIM card into this thing at some point when I feel like doing that. Looks like there's two Raspberry Pi camera connections up there. What else? We have the SIM card. We have TF, otherwise known as SD card. Power switch. DC 12 volts in. A couple of USB-A's. Headphone jack. HDMI. Ethernet. UART connection. That looks like a USB-C. And it is. We have an RS-232, good old serial port. Oh, nice. Not a lot of devices have serial ports on them anymore. And then over here, we have GPIO, two different GPIOs, a ground and a 3-volt. We have two relays here, normally open, normally closed, and common for both of those. Digital in and out, two each of those, and then ground and 3 and 5 volts. And then we have CAN bus. We have analog to digital converter, and we have an RS-485 connection over here. And then looking in the top, we have the standard Raspberry Pi 40-pin GPIO header, pin header, I guess. That's what you'd call that. And it comes with a 64 gig SD card in there, which I believe has preloaded Raspbian on it. So what does this manual say? They talk about Node RED quite a bit on this thing, and any Raspberry Pi can do Node RED, can be a Node RED server, and that's actually quite common. I haven't played with that before, so I'm not going to spend a lot of time on that right now. I might in the future, but I have a lot of learning to do on that whole software platform. In the manual, we also have some specs. It's a 1024 by 600 7-inch screen, 5-point capacitive touch. Wi-Fi 2.4 and 5 gigs on the compute module. Bluetooth 5 on the compute module. That's standard for compute modules. We have LoRa and or LTE on mini PCIe sockets. Ethernet, yeah, we saw that. HDMI, 4K at 60 FPS max, sure. Audio, USB, power. Oh, it can be powered from between 12 and 36 volts. That's interesting to note. Oh, I can power it from power over Ethernet as well. And then there's fan and speaker outputs. So the front panel is rated at IP65. Not the whole thing, obviously, because crap can get in there, but just this front panel module. So I guess if you sink this into a rated case and seal it up with proper gasketing, then the whole thing would maintain its IP65, I guess. Oh, and you can put in an SSD as well. Ooh. So I think before I power this thing on, because you know what channel you're on, I think I am going to pop the back cover off this and just take a look at the hardware underneath there. So I had to unplug the fan from the motherboard here, but that's not a big deal. And here are all my various different modules in here. So there is the compute module 4. The compute module 4 is, it's basically the same as a standard Raspberry Pi 4B, but it doesn't have all of the hardware or the connectors on it. It's got a couple of bulk connectors on the back. So it is designed for integrating into a larger piece of equipment like this. Oh, I did get a LoRa module on this. Okay, I wasn't sure. I didn't think I was going to get one. So then this is the cellular modem. Wow, okay. So I guess I could also, in place of the LoRa module, put in, yeah, there's for an NVMe drive. Okay, there's the mounting screw for that. So I guess before I start playing with this LoRa stuff, first of all, I'll need something for it to talk to, but more importantly, I'll have to make sure that this particular one is capable of communicating in the North American legal frequencies, because from one continent to another, there are different legal frequencies for different things. And I know LoRa in North America is, I think, 915 meg. In some countries, it's 300 and some meg, I believe. And in the meantime, if I'm going to be using this thing for much, I'd probably replace that with the NVMe drive. Anyway, on here we can see, okay, so there's some power over Ethernet headers there. There is the relay. What else? We have a button cell for clock, probably. There's some power supply gubbins up there. We have a buzzer on the back there. Cool, that's a fairly neatly put together board. So for antennas, we've got four antennas coming off there. That one is going to be the Bluetooth antenna. That one is obviously the LoRa antenna. So these other two, that one is LTE, and that one is what? Huh? Oh, that's the Wi-Fi on there. Okay. So, that's the GPS is on the cellular modem. Okay. Well, that's cool. Yes, I will put this back together and finally get around to putting some power on it and firing it up. That all comes apart and goes back together very smoothly. Four screws around the outside, all the same length, and one shorter one right in the middle. So down here, we'll plug the power in and plug it in and see what happens. I guess hit the power switch. Okay, we have a light. That's the active, that's the power. Okay, I don't know what the user light is for. It booted up with a control panel going on here. Okay, I don't know what that is doing or if that is just showing random stuff. Okay, so I can control it, sure. Ah, it looks like it is a demo over here, okay. There's something. So we have parameter page. That just shows that, right? Load Raspbian, which is the standard desktop. So that was a pretty cool little dashboard that they had going on there, though. Let's see what we got over there. Wireless. It's seeing a few different Wi-Fis, and that's good. Well, because my fingers are a little bit big for this touch screen, I've connected a mouse to it just to make it easier, and we can go through and just see what's pre-installed on here. Under programming, we've got Thonny, which is the Python IDE, and Gianni, which is just a lightweight IDE. We've got Chromium and Minicom, Minicom being a serial terminal kind of a thing. Audio control, VLC media player, standard stuff. Image viewer and a little paint program. All these standard things, Pi imager, PDF viewer, Pi diagnostics, SD card copier, a terminal, text two text editors plus Vim, so three text editors. Onboard, which is a on-screen keyboard, which can be handy. And then standard preferences setup. Run, which is also there. Okay, and a file manager. So with all the talking about Node-RED that they did, I'm going to assume that it is already pre-installed. And Chromium has a link to it. Cool. And there it is. Because Node-RED is very much network aware, actually it kind of requires network to do anything useful, I have connected my my Pi device here up to my Ethernet and access Node-RED through my web browser on my main computer so that I can actually share the screen with you. Now then, I, as I said, don't know much about Node-RED, but it's a drag and drop kind of programming environment. You connect input things to output things just by dragging these wires to each other. Apparently this is really good for home automation kind of stuff and that sort of thing. So if so, that would mean that this thing can be used as a really convenient dashboard for all your home automation needs. But as I said, right now I'm not really into too much home automation stuff, but I think that could be what this guy is supposed to be doing. I've been playing around with this thing a little bit, and I've got VNC running so that I can actually do sort of screen capture on it, so you can see what's going on here. And I've also installed a QLink controller on this Crow Panel device, and it actually works from the touchscreen, as you can see there, which is pretty cool. Unfortunately, my aim is a little off on the touchscreen thing, but it does actually work, which is neat. Come on, there, grab that. So that's pretty nifty. And I can create some virtual console things if I can figure out. This is a Q8 problem. I haven't figured out how to create these, but I can create buttons and stuff that I can actually hit with my fingers rather than needing to use that. So that's one potential use that I can put this thing to. But there are so many other possibilities that I'm going to have to spend a lot of time researching. At the moment I'm just using my USB, but since there is a CAN bus and an RS-485 output on here, I should be able to direct Q-Lite to that. I haven't figured it out, like, so much. Again, this is not intended to be a deep dive on this device. This is supposed to be just an unboxing and a quick hardware overview. And to that end, since it is just a quick overview, let's take a look at the web page. This thing is currently selling for $152 American. There are several different options you can get with it. You can get either the European or the US frequency LoRa module. You get the North American or EU or global frequency cellular module, the antenna kit, which is what I got with it, and things like that. There is a full description of it there. Link, of course, is down below if you want to read it, or you can just pause it and take a look more carefully. The important bits, at least from what I can tell, is that it runs on a Raspberry Pi CM4, compute module 4. It has that touch screen. Several places in here they call it industrial grade. You can make your own decisions based on what you're seeing, but there is the pinouts for all those connectors on the side of it again. And as I said, I have to figure out this RS485 because that could be cool for connecting directly to DMX. And it's not a hardware issue. It's just a Raspberry Pi software issue that I've got to figure out. And I've got to find some more documentation. There is some documentation attached to this page that I'll link you to. Down here at the bottom, there's a wiki and a copy of the manual. But here is that wiki that it goes to. And that's it's a fairly lengthy document. It has, you know, all this stuff here and a few tutorials, but only really a Node-RID tutorial, which again, I haven't gone through because I don't have anything else that's talking Node-RID at the moment. So it's kind of not really useful for me at this time, but I'm hoping to spend some more time figuring that out in the future with the help of some other tutorials from my buddy, another maker. I'll also link to those down below. The only thing that's missing from all this documentation is a lot more software related stuff. Like, what software do I need to get the 4G module running, for instance, or what software do I need to get the LoRa module running? That kind of thing. But that is beyond the scope of this video. Right now, as I said, we're just looking at the hardware. All in all, it is a very capable device, and there will be links down below. I'm not getting any commission on any of this. I'm not getting any kickbacks. I'm not getting paid for this. I'm just getting this piece of hardware to play with in the future. And that's exactly what I shall do in the future. I hope you found that somewhat informative. As I said, there will be links down below if you want to find out more about this thing. Thanks for watching. Thanks to Elecrow for sending it over for me to take a peek at. I will talk to you later.